came to Paris as Emily from Chicago, and Emily is still Emily, who loves color, prints, styles, textures, shapes, all of the above. But there's an elevated, slightly Parisian flair about what she is wearing this season.
Bonjour, Sylvie. When did you get back to Paris?
This morning.
Season two, certainly Emily's wardrobe evolves. She's a character who has a lot of fun with fashion. I think the audience enjoys seeing that.
Spray away!
I think Patricia and Marilyn just do an amazing job of making the wardrobe its own character in the series.
It was very important for me for season two not to repeat season one. I wanted to show our audience some new ideas.
J'ai pas voulu sur la saison 2 justement que Emily soit directement trop chic. Pour moi, de l'avoir trop chic ou trop francisée, ça aurait voulu dire que sa personnalité n'était plus aussi forte. Donc on reste sur ces silhouettes très éclectiques, très colorées.
We need to get on a yacht before we leave Saint-Tropez.
Je suis désolée. No girls allowed.
Get on the boat. We've incorporated more purples and violets, as well as yellows and chartreuses, bold colors. Nothing too overwhelming, but very much just Emily.
Nous faire shopping vêtements maintenant?
Oui, j'aime beaucoup faire du shopping.
I wanted to introduce these gloves that I personally enjoy wearing. Gloves were from a bygone time, and today the only reason we wear gloves is to stay warm when it's cold. So it's a new accessory in a way for this generation, but it's a young accessory.
Mon leitmotiv sur toute cette série, la saison 1 et la saison 2, ça a été too much good taste can be boring.
That was your presentation? That my clothes are amusant? But you know that that means funny looking. I'm always surprised by what Pat and Marilyn show me, and we have hours and hours of fittings and photos, and it's just my dream.
I think as we move forward with some of the other characters, each one of them establishes their very own specific fashion identity.
We get to see each and everyone's color. You know, Emily and their bucket hats. Mindy is really going into those Broadway-like costumes, very bold ideas. Gabrielle is going into this autumn palette. Camille's pure French fashion. It is a statement of their personalities.
Antoine, this is my friend Mindy.
Oh, enchanté.
Coming from the theater world and even on screen, I think that costumes play such a big part in the physicality and the temperature of that character. And I always feel like I'm much more Mindy when I'm literally in her shoes. Patricia Field had this vision for Mindy's first costume at the drag club, which was designed handmade by the Blondes. And they made this incredible, exquisite half man, half woman costume.
It's about being in a scene with the appropriate costume so that it's telling something about the character at that moment.
Oh my God!
There's a dress that was made by this project called Renaissance Project. That dress for me, I mean, it was made for me in the boat, so I love it.
We all have such a specific aesthetic, and I love it. When we're all together, you really see like a symphony of design.
In season two, the looks are even more powerful. There is so many scenes when I'm wearing some Balmain jacket and they have huge shoulders and it's really like a statement.
I would like to make a toast too.
Camille est dans un code couleur très monochromatique, comme Sylvie, comme un petit peu Gabrielle.
I tend to want to push Patricia and Marilyn to bring me pieces that are a little more, you know, colorful and crazy, but this is not the character. He likes texture and it's a lot of burgundy and orange.
I think people like color and need color these days. When we aired episode one, I heard over and over again, it was so much fun to watch that it was a lift. I heard it over and over again, and that made me extremely happy.
That gets me every time.